I grew up in the oldest continuously inhabited city in Europe. Plovdiv in Bulgaria. For over 6,000 years, people have roamed the streets and left a legacy of art, culture, architecture, and pure human resilience. Plovdiv is a city of layers. With every single dig, we uncover another civilization from times before. With every single dig, we uncover new artifacts that are not only a window into the past, but a window into the future. Because think about it. 100 years from today, 1,000 years from today, when people dig to uncover our time, what will they see? Plastic bottles. So today, I'm here to tell you about three plastic paradoxes in a paradigm shift. Paradox number one. Plastic was a solution, and it's now a problem. Plastic was invented as a substitute for ivory and tortoise shells, because we made piano keys and billiard balls out of ivory. We made ornaments and combs out of tortoise shells. To save the elephants, to save the turtles, humanity invented plastic. In 1908, Bakelite was patented, the first fully synthetic plastic. It helped. We used less animal parts, but it also hurt. Today, our plastic footprint is over 460 million tons. That is more than the weight of all human beings on Earth combined. And one third of that is single-use plastics. The bottles, the bags that we use for minutes but persist for centuries. Imagine this. We produce 500 billion plastic bottles a year. If you were to line them up in trucks, they will go from New York to Bangkok. And that's every year. In this country, we use 383 bottles a year. That's one a day for every baby, child, and adult, and then some. In 1 liter of plastic water bottle, you will find 240,000 observable particles of plastic. And that leads us to paradox number two. The cost of convenience. It's so easy to grab a plastic water bottle. There are several lying around. But what does that do? What does that do to us? What does it do to the environment? What does it do to other living species? What it does to us, we are now discovering. Plastic particles, microplastics, are in human blood, brain, and yes, in 100% of testicles tested, human and canine. That means we have plastic in our systems from conception on. And plastic is everywhere in the environment. From the depths of the Mariana Trench to the heights of Mount Everest. Artist Benjamin Fan Wong of Canada has really captured the power of the choices we make and that we shouldn't make. It is time to turn off the tap. It's not enough to recycle. We have to turn off the tap. This 30-foot sculpture greeted international delegates at the UN Environment Assembly in Nairobi in 2022. And there they were to discuss paradox number three. Is it up to us as individuals, you, me, all of us, to say, I'm not going to take that bottle. I'll choose something else. Where will I find different shampoo? Or is it up to a collective choice? And how do we make those collective choices? Because if it's up to us and we recycle, only 9% of what we put in the recycling bin is actually recycled. The rest goes to landfill, into the ocean, some incinerated. And so this is where collective action comes in. But collective action doesn't happen on its own. Someone has to lead it. At the international level, Rwanda led it. Rwanda is a small state, the size of Massachusetts exactly, that said, we're going to ban the use, the sale, and the production of single-use plastics in 2008. And they said, if we can, so can you, and so should you. So Rwanda led the global treaty process on eliminating plastic pollution. I've been working in Rwanda since 2017, and in 2022, the government invited me to be on that delegation to work toward a global treaty. We're meeting next week in South Korea to see how far we can go, but then we'll have to meet again after January, and you know why. Rwanda has led and has shown the power of small states. It was Rwanda and Peru who put that proposal on the international table. And we've written, no, we have filmed a story about it. As a result, countries have followed. There are now more than 100 countries who have banned plastics in one way or another. But leaving it to consumers or to countries is not enough. We need leadership from the middle out. We need cities, companies, and campuses. Cities are already on it. 500 plus cities in the US have some form of a plastic bag ban. Companies are investing in different materials. They're also rethinking their business model. And campuses, universities, 80 universities in the United States have some policy regarding single-use plastic. But we're in Boston. This is the center of gravity of academia. So what are we doing? There are 50-plus universities in Boston. Studies have shown that when 20% of a group lead, the rest follow. Do the math. Let's get 11 presidents. And yes, I will say, Northeastern, please, lead the group. If we have 11 presidents of campuses to rethink research, procurement, and education, the students will follow. There will be ripple effect around the world. And this is the paradigm shift. We need to move away from the negativity, from our negative impact of our footprint on Earth, to the positive influence of our handprints. What is the positivity that we bring to the world? We've done it before. Do you remember being on a plane where people could smoke? Being in a classroom where teachers smoked? You can't do that today. Smoking is banned, but it's also unsophisticated. This is what we could do with plastics. The products like bags and bottles and balloons are not only unnecessary, they're harmful. And we have done it there too. The country of Seychelles, an archipelago and a celebration destination, has actually banned balloons because they harm the ocean and all of the species within it. So what I'd like you to think about today is that beauty will save the world. And that is what Dostoevsky said. And it is art that will change our minds because it will connect minds and hearts. Innocent Nkurunziza, an artist in Rwanda, creates his art on renewable tree bark. He paints people and spirals, upward spirals of consciousness. Today is the time when we can make this choice. And I would like to ask you one question as you leave today. What handprint will you leave? Thank you.